I spoke with Mr. Green, and we have discovered the location of the British Indies secret headquarters. You are to meet him, and he will give you the details. There is a foundry nearby where the Templars and BIC members have been meeting on a regular basis. Mr. Green waits for you there.
But we still don't understand why they tried to frame you.
We don't, but Mr. Green seemed to think that they're using the factory to develop something. It's a good place to start digging. Good luck.
You made it.
You found the British Indies Company hideout?
They've taken over an abandoned foundry. It's heavily fortified, and word has it, they're shipping something precious overseas.
My gut tells me that something precious is something bad.
My thoughts exactly. Go find out what they're protecting and destroy it. Maybe you'll discover why they're after Mr. Singh.
So this is where they've been keeping that sleeping gas. They can't leave London. War? I must destroy them.
Someone should alert the authorities, shouldn't they?
Thank you.
Yes. Go fetch the manager. I'd better get a closer look.
Destroyed? How?
There's someone in the vicinity! A spy!
One of those rocks, I wager!
It must be those damned renegades Singer's friends with. Who knew one caged bird could cause so much trouble?
You're caught, Ellsworth. Give up.
I knew you had something to do with this. Seize him!
He got away. I must tell Singer this news immediately.
What did you find out? Who's behind all of this?
You're not gonna like what I have to tell you, Your Highness. Brinley Ellsworth is behind the attacks.
Ellsworth?
He was gone before I had a chance to follow him. But we need to track him down and put an end to this before anything worse happens.
I need some time to think on this.
We'll get them next time, boss.
Next time, don't draw so much attention.
The storm of money!
Yeah, of course.
What's going on?
You're amazing. Thank you.
Nothing but the eyes! Excellent choice. Hope to see you again.
I hope you like my new office, Miss Frye. As you can see, my informants have found some promising leads. Evidence of spy activity has surfaced around the Field Hospital, St. Catherine's Docks, and the Tower of London. I needn't remind you how crucial it is that we put a stop to these infiltrators.
I once loathed the very sight of your kind, in the same way you recoil in the presence of an arachnid. Humans were created by we who came before, the Isu. We crafted you in our image, but deprived you of our true gifts. You were bred for hard labor, and in extreme cases, war. We built great observatories to monitor you, devices to control you. We blessed you with resilience, but cursed you with ambition. And so you rebelled against us. I suppose we are to blame for the state of your species. Is it any wonder so many of these simulations revolve around violence?
One of the spies is posing as a nurse in the nearby facilities. She has been taking blood samples into odd-looking cubes and delivering them to an unknown accomplice. Perhaps you will be able to spot them during one of these illicit rendezvous. Good luck.
Forever!
people clashed, we became distracted from an impending doom. A coronal mass ejection from our angry sun. The greatest minds of our time assembled to prevent the coming disaster. Among them, forthright Minerva, proud Jupiter, beloved Aeta. We spent years locked away in the Grand Temple, attempting to find salvation. The others could only think of physical solutions. Yet I believed the only way to save us was to transform us. Inspired by the research of the great scientist Consus, I attempted to place Aeta's mind into a stronger synthetic body. I failed, and my beloved died in my arms. The others shunned me.
Yeah!
very much.
Miss Frye, I believe I'm quite getting the hang of this espionage business. This one should be of particular interest to you. One of the spies currently detained at the tower has been making some rather fanciful claims about a Brotherhood of Assassins. You may want to silence him before he causes you and your associates undue trouble. Consider it my gift to you.
Came to nothing. In the year 2306 of the Isu era, the sun unleashed its fury on my once great civilization. I perfected the work of Consus and made it my own. I salvaged Aita's brilliant essence and inserted it into the DNA of your rebellious kind. I sent him into the unknown future to be reborn again and again. I returned to the Grand Temple. I shed my physical form and entered the Grey. But stubborn Minerva and foolish Jupiter discovered me and sealed me inside. Entombed, I waited for the day when your technology might allow my return. That wait is nearly over.
What? That's absurd!
has uncovered the location of the sinister cult of spies plaguing our streets. You know your orders, lads. Follow her lead, and let us rid London of this menace.
That's the way to do it!
Excellent work. The ringleader is dead, as are his bizarre disciples.
Is that it, then?
Well, there is still a war on.
Then we both have our own affairs to attend to.
Know that you have done a great service to your country. Thank you.
I'm pleased.
Thank you. more signs of network disturbance. What happened in there?
Good, you're here. His Highness seems to have caught a mild case of madness this morning.
You were right when you said that this was our chance.
I was.
I propose we make a commotion, lure out the Templar-controlled British Indies Company.
And do what? Put yourself in the line of fire?
I need to send Ellsworth a message. This won't be over until we can draw him out. This is something I must do. I will make a scene, and then you need to rough them up in it.
Well, that shouldn't be a problem.
I've heard you Templars are a bunch of pansies.
Here we go.
I need you to send a message to Ellsworth.
I'll do anything!
Tell him to meet me at Lambeth Cemetery tonight, and tell him to come alone.
I hear murder!
Meet me tonight at Lambeth Cemetery.
Murder!
He'll never come alone, even if I ask him to.
Someone's been killed!
Am I going to have to teach you some manners?
Good God.
You can get away, you two.
This ain't good.
He's making a run for it.
When there's arse on to worry about.
No point, no problem. Maybe next time.
Let's go. Yeah. He's in.
Caused quite a commotion.
He's gone mad. Greeny was right.
He isn't mad, Jacob. He's trying to take action. To do the right thing. Oh, never mind. I'll take it from here.
Fine by me. I could use a good pint right about now.
I was expecting Jacob, but I'm glad it's you who have come.
He thinks you've gone mad.
I probably have.
What's your plan?
I've asked Brinley to meet me here alone. In turn, he, of course, has sent a small army to secure the area. I need you to get rid of them and meet me back here. It's essential that when Brinley does arrive, I have him to myself.
Understood.
Here.
That'll certainly help quite a bit, thank you.
He's here.
I must talk to him.
Don't be absurd, this is dangerous.
Miss Frye, this is something I must do, and I must do it alone. Remain hidden. I cannot afford to have him see you.
You can't escape me forever, Your Highness. Come out and face me.
Dare come to this meeting place alone, not with your recently acquired friends.
I am alone, Elswood.
You can't just walk this earth like a free man. You are nothing more than a trophy, a stag's head above a mantelpiece. You've caused enough commotion as it is. It's time to put an end to this.
If you kill me now, you will be... Imagine the uprising when they find out the only son of Ranjit Singh has been murdered. Elswood, listen.
I've had enough of this.
I knew you were lying.
No, you mustn't!
He will kill you!
This is what I was sent here for. Be done with it, girl! I shall never forfeit my own mission.
I will not allow it.
The Loggins, the company, they all wanted your silence. Whether you spare me or end me, you won't escape the fate they have planned for you.
It seems you have learnt nothing of India, of its people. But killing you? That is something I cannot do. It would make me no better than the cursed, oppressive company you work for.
You will die as you were raised, Singh. You'll never be more than a trophy of war. We will bury you in English soil.
You have done me much good. I am heavily indebted to you both.
We are happy to help.
I fear that I cannot continue handling things in this manner. The assassin way is not my way. As helpful as you have been, this empire, this land, my people, the problem is so much bigger than death. I know I must devote my life to this cause, to put India, my home, back onto the map, return it to its people. It's a long and grueling journey, but it is something I must do, even if it takes me to my own death.
We understand, Your Highness.
But if you do change your mind, you know where to find us.
That I do. Thank you, assassins. Hopefully we never shall meet again.
Henry's in a foul mood. Lover spat,